From Utah is recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I appreciate that. I think a couple of the speakers have given what is one of the crux problems, not of this, the Santa Cruz Heritage Area, but of the overall issue itself. The gentleman from Arizona, who does a good job in representing his constituents, did say there are 49 heritage areas. There have been heritage areas for the last 25 years, and therein is the problem. When Mo Udall was chairman of that committee, and Bruce Vento was the subcommittee chairman, that's the first time this concept of a heritage area was introduced. The concept was going to be that this was startup money, and then the heritage areas would be on their own. Bruce Vento did say, 10 years and we are out of there. This was never supposed to be a 25-year program for any of these areas. Problem is that when the 10 years are up, we keep extending the time limit on these areas, and we keep extending the life and giving more and more money to these areas. In fact, it has become part that there is a cottage industry that has developed going out to areas to train them on how they can become a heritage area and stay a heritage area to get more and more funding. It violates the very concept of why heritage areas were there in the first place. This year alone, we have added 9 new heritage areas. This bill itself has $15 million, which is a 50% increase on what the majority of heritage areas do receive. The problem is very simple. This heritage area is to try to expand its tourism and other elements, and other areas pay for it. So if you're in tourist area A, you are now being taxed, and your money will go to promote tourism in area B. And if that was simply a startup fund, simply to get them starting, none of us really have objections to that. But it isn't. It's becoming perpetual as we extend and extend and spend more and more on these elements. This particular heritage area in front of us covers 3,300 square miles, private and public land. When Republicans were in charge of this committee, as a standard, we always included language in heritage area legislation that gave property owners the ability to opt out of boundaries. It was a compromise. It was weak, but at least it was there. What we're trying to say in that is that people should have a voice in what is done to them. People should be given choices, actions, and we should not refrain from doing that. We should not have the government setting what the standard is, what the boundary is, what the requirements is, and there are instances when outside groups have tried to pressure local zoning entities because of these boundaries. It is not right that people should be locked inside a boundary, oftentimes with little prior knowledge of what is actually happening, because boundaries do have consequences. Otherwise, why have those boundaries? If these heritage areas are so innocuous, there is no reason to lock an owner in. Give them the opportunity for full information so they can make decisions, and again, give them the choices of what they wish to do. That is what, that is how we should be treating individuals and property owners. This area is one that has heavily traveled with narcotic trafficking, human trafficking, and there is, and now I appreciate the fact that the gentleman from Arizona and the Rules Committee in a self-executing rule did give some modicum of protection on these areas. As late as last July, we attempted in the committee to try and put language similar to this to try and give some protection on these areas. Rejected, not on a partisan vote, because several of the opposition side actually did vote with us, but nonetheless rejected in committee. I am proud of Representative Grijalva for now including this language in this bill, but it could be better, and that's the issue before us. Last week, or less than a week ago, the GAO revealed that secure border initiatives are behind schedule, are years behind schedule, because of environmental delays. That simply means there are people out there within the National Park Service that blame the Border Patrol for environmental damage. The Park Service's own admission is that it takes 6 months to complete documents necessary to place critical border security technologies like observation towers. There's one tower that was stopped on these border particular areas until they prove in some kind of scientific study that the Sonoran pronghorn deer would leave that area of their own volition and would not be scared by these towers. I'm sorry, that's ridiculous. But that's the reality in the reality of why we are here and the reality of what is happening. So there are some concerns with this area. The majority did put language in there to try and protect border security and the border areas, and I'm thankful for that, and I applaud you for doing that. But you could have taken a big step further. This bill still needs, you did put some language in there to try and protect personal property, but you could have gone further just simply to say people should have the choice and the option of what they are doing. And once again, we have a problem of heritage areas, supposed to be temporary, supposed to be startup, staying year after year after year, getting fund after fund after fund of public money from point A to fund the exact thing that is happening in point B in competition with point A. We have to rethink this thing, which is indeed what the Park Service asked us to do several years ago, to not produce any more of these heritage areas until we come up with a comprehensive plan of how we are going to function with these heritage areas. With that, Mr. Speaker, once again, this is the Republic will not falter if this bill passes, but it could have been much, much better. And it could have done much more to protect not only our border security, but also the rights of individuals than what we are doing here. Some good steps forward, I admit, but we have a long, long way to go. And once again, we still have the problem of what to do with heritage areas who are supposed to be temporary and simply will not go away. Mr. Speaker, I yield back the balance of my time.
Gentleman yields back the balance of his time.
Mr. Speaker, I reserve the balance of my time. I apologize since I am now taking over committing this. I would ask the gentleman from Arizona if he actually has any more speakers.
No.
Then in that situation, now I will officially